Hello, Gemini. What's going on, you guys? I'm back. I had to take a little bit of a breather, but I'm back. All right, so this is for you guys. If you're Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Gemini, this is your love reading, July 1st through July 15th, 2019. Hit the subscribe button if you like. If it resonates, like, share, subscribe, do all that good stuff. All my info is below. If you guys need a private reading, phone readings are going away in about a week. Well, the special is. So you can use it whenever you like, but you got to book within the month of June. All right, Gemini, let's see what's coming in. Also, follow me on Instagram if you like. It's all below. All right, let's take a big fat look at your big fat fuck. Hi. That reminds me, I have a really bad mouth. So click off if that bothers you, but I don't know. It just comes out, Gemini, and I've just stopped trying to filter it. So, all right, love energy for Gemini, please. What's coming their way in love? July 1st through July 15th, 2019. What's up? What is up for Gemini? All right, you guys, I did pre-shuffle, so we are set to go, and we're doing it. Here we go. Let's check it. All right, coming into the current moment, what do we have? We have the Devil in reverse, Gemini, sign of Capricorn. All right, what's your challenge? We have the Lovers. Hi, thanks for showing up, Lovers. That's you guys, Gemini. On your mind is the Ace of Cups. La, 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 la. Gemini, are you in love? Recent past, what do we have? The Page of Wands in reverse. Fire energy, Leo, Sag, Aries. What's the situation? Why is all this happening? We have the Nine of Swords in reverse. There's your energy. Coming into the near future, what will you experience? The Ten of Cups in reverse. All right. How do you see yourself right now? What do we got? The Two of Cups in reverse. Gemini, what the hell is up? Outside influences. So the person you're dealing with or thinking about, what kind of energy are they bringing your way? The Ace of Wands. Somebody is feeling the passion. All right. What's in your emotions? What's going on? We have the Five of Cups in reverse. Take a look at this Five of Cups in this deck. I'm sorry. It's the Four of Cups in reverse. Mom here has a hard time reading Roman numerals sometimes. What's the outcome? What do we have? And we have the Ten of Coins in reverse. All right, Gemini, let me take a look. What's at the bottom of the deck for your overall energy? We have the King of Coins. Some of you guys are dealing with an earth sign, Virgo, a Capricorn, Taurus. Maybe they have that in their chart somewhere. If not, this King of Coins, some of you guys are married to this person. All right, it's a strong commitment. This person's usually very reliable, stable, grounded, all that good shit. Here, let's put this down a little bit. All right. So again, some of you guys are married or in a long-term relationship with this King of Coins type energy. Doesn't have to be an earth sign, but that's what I'm seeing. Do have a lot of we have Capricorn here coming into the current moment too. So it could be their Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. It's, you know, this person's typically very strong in business and career, money, that kind of shit. Dad, husband, material. There's a commitment here, okay? Now coming in though, we have the Devil in reverse. So see, major for Capricorn. That Devil in reverse, somebody's releasing though. The Devil in reverse is like, I don't feel that strong tie and bond to you, all right? Releasing, no longer feeling restricted, or just relieving toxicities within the relationship, addictions, fear, obsessions, that kind of shit. The challenge or what's influencing that is you guys, the Lovers. Major arcana for Gemini. So this is a relationship, okay? Somebody's gonna have to make a choice. You may be trying to choose between two different people because that Lover's energy is making a head over heart decision, okay? Soulmate shit. On your mind is the Ace of Cups. So maybe you guys have new love on your mind, okay? Getting the, for some of you guys, you're dealing with somebody, but then you have like new love on your mind and you're trying to make a decision possibly, either you or the other person. Now the recent past with the Page of Wands in reverse. So not communicating, but also the Page of Wands in the upright is fun, young, vibrant, like wants to get out there and see the world, do things together, passion, but that died in the recent past. Somebody may have gotten some bad news, or it's like the communication and the passion is just kind of taking a back seat. All right, let's see. I was just taking a look at this. We have the Eight of Swords actually in the reverse here in the situation. Mom counted wrong. It's the Eight of Swords. All right. So the situation, there's a lot of release here. Gemini, I think either you or the other person's found new love, or you have a new love on your mind and you're letting somebody go. Some of you, it's an earth sign that you're with and you're letting that person go, or this could be the new person too. Take it how it resonates. It could be vice versa. Eight of Swords is no longer feeling trapped. It's release. It's no longer feeling stuck, and it's just kind of releasing yourself. Because what you'll experience coming into the near future is the Ten of Cups in reverse. So see, this could be a divorce or a breakup. Somebody's just not happy, obviously. Ten of Cups in reverse, you know? It's a completion of a cycle here, and it's due to somebody releasing, but you have Ace of Cups on your mind. You're either healing, because the Ace of Cups can be self-love, or you have new love on your mind. You see yourself right now as the Two of Cups in reverse, getting out of something, all right? Breaking up. Not seeing eye to eye. We've got a strong connection here. Lovers, Two of Cups. But they're both kind of in the challenge position, if you will. Now, somebody in your environment is bringing a passionate new beginning. This is another ace. Could be new love, new passion, new spark. Somebody feels very attracted to you and wants to get some type of passionate new beginning going. All right? Because, Gemini, because in your emotions, you have the Four of Cups in reverse. See, you see something as a missed opportunity. I feel like it's like you guys, for the majority, releasing this. Because you know, like, you have to miss an opportunity with somebody, and it could be to get new love. Now, the outcome, we have the Ten of Coins in reverse. See, another 10. Completion. You guys are completing a cycle. More earth energy, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. Again, a divorce, a breakup. Completion coming in, and then in the outcome, same thing. I feel like some of you are in a relationship, possibly with this King of Coins type energy. And if it's not an earth sign, that's okay. It's just the energy of like long-term, stable, grounded, practical, that kind of shit. But let's see what's going on here. Okay, so Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. What do we see for Gemini? July 1st through July 15th, 2019. Y'all know time's fluid. All right, it is. So look back on it. If you're like, what the fuck? This doesn't make any sense. I don't know. Take a look down the road. Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. What do we see in their love life, please, for Gemini? July 1st through July 15th, 2018. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Two more shuffles because, well, that's what I feel I need to do. Two more. Gemini in love, please. What do we see? July 1st through July 15th, 2019. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Gemini. Let's cut her and do her and then chat about her, Gemini. Let's see what's up. All right. All right. So this overall energy, Gemini, we have the King of Coins. So let's clarify this. Who's this King of Coins for Gemini, please? Who is this King of Coins? Clarify this overall energy of the King of Coins. Yeah, the Emperor. Strong ass energy here. This is husband, long-term relationship type shit. Could be an Aries. They may have Aries or Earth in their chart somewhere. Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. Okay, husband, long-term commitment. Somebody that is nurturing, loving, but very grounded and very stable. Is all about practicality and setting the rules. All right, so this is the overall energy. This is who you're dealing with and releasing, or this is who you're going towards. Take it how it resonates. But coming in right now, we have the Devil in reverse, Capricorn energy, letting go. You might be letting go of a Capricorn, releasing. Why is the Devil in reverse here for Gemini? What is it? Yeah, the Tower. Boom, sign of Scorpio. Okay, some of you are releasing a Scorpio, but also too with the Tower energy, something very unexpected has come in here. Could be new love, and you guys are releasing somebody else, possibly. What's this Tower energy? Breakup, that kind of shit. The Eight of Swords, really in your head about it, about what to do here. I'm getting the sense that some of you guys were in a relationship and maybe found new love, or vice versa. It's kind of what it's feeling like. What's this Eight of Swords about? The Page of Pentacles, but not being able to invest in something because you still feel trapped to something else. That's what I'm getting. Now, the challenge is the Lovers. You could be your own challenge, Gemini, but it's to make a decision, I think. Why is the Lovers here, please, between two people? The Empress, Taurus, Libra, and energy. Some of you are a wife, a mother, that kind of shit. But the Empress is all about newness and abundance, expansion, growth, fertility. She's ruled by Venus, so she's all about love. But we have a love, for some of you guys, this is a love triangle type shit. All right, why is the Empress here? Why is this the challenge? Yeah, the Hierophant. Somebody's married or in a relationship here. I'm just saying, and that's going to be the challenge, all right? There's new love here, but somebody else is tied down. Why is the Page of Wands in the reverse for the past? Why is this here for Gemini? The Five of Wands in reverse. Maybe cutting communication or not really feeling the passion and wanting to just leave strife behind. Five is all about strife and challenges, but it's also change. It brings change here. Why is this Five of Wands in reverse? The Page of Swords, you may have communicated that to somebody too. Page of Swords, that's your energy, Gemini. Somebody may have been keeping an eye on somebody, or it could just be very blunt communication, very to the point. Tell me more about the Page of Swords. What is this? Yeah, the Three of Pentacles. There's a love triangle going on here, people. I'm just saying. Three of Pentacles in reverse is like, I no longer want to work with you. I no longer want to build. I no longer see teamwork in our lives here. You may have communicated that to somebody, or there could have been very blunt to the point communication about, you know, some type of love triangle. Because on your mind, Gemini is the Ace of Cups. So why is this on Gemini's mind? What's this Ace of Cups? Yeah, the Three of Swords in reverse. See? Another three. I just got to point it out like I see it. I do. Why is the Three of Swords here? Ace of Cups is new love. It's healing energy. And so is that Three of Swords in reverse. But not really looking at it like that. Why is the Three of Swords here in reverse for Gemini? The Two of Wands. So there's no plans being made here. Somebody cannot take action in this situation because they still feel tied to a situation. All right. Now, we have here in the foundation the Eight of Swords in reverse. It's all about letting go, getting out of that mental prison, not feeling stuck. Why is the Eight of Swords here in the foundation for Gemini? Why is it? What do we got? The Five of Cups in reverse. Releasing and getting over the past. Not really, you know, stuck in it. You know, not having those regrets. Realizing that though you or the other person's releasing from this, you know, you still have love to offer. Let's see what the Five of Cups. This is why everything's happening. Why is this Five of Cups here? The Four of Wands, so a lack of stability or a breakup. Somebody's releasing here, you guys, they are. And I feel like also with that Five of Cups in reverse in the foundation, again, it's realizing that the Three have spilled, but you still have new love or love to offer, but it can't happen right now for some reason. So coming in, what you'll experience is the Ten of Cups in reverse. Why is this coming in for Gemini? A completion, strength in reverse. Some of you guys are dealing with a Leo, or they could have Leo in their chart. Feeling tired, you know? A lot of you are just gonna experience feeling emotionally drained because I do feel that there's some decisions that need to be made in love, and it's gonna be very difficult to do that. And so with strength in reverse, it's like, I'm just too tired to deal with this shit. There's some obstacles that you have to overcome, but you may just lay it to rest for a little bit because you just don't have the confidence to move forward. There's a lot of like feeling drained and, you know, slightly depressed and fatigued. Yeah, and with the Hermit energy, Virgo, could be dealing with a Virgo, could be that King of Cups or King of Coins. Some of you have Virgo in your chart. You're going to really be going within and trying to figure some shit out. That Hermit energy is shining that lantern on exactly what needs to be uncovered or figured out. So kind of going within here, maybe seeking some advice, some wisdom. What's this Hermit about? Yeah, the world. So see, the Hermit is shining the lantern right on the world, okay? The world is an ending and a new beginning, okay? So some of you are really going to be reflecting that coming into the near future because I feel a lot of you guys are just not happy. And you either have a new person on your mind or you just want to go towards that. Why the world? The Knight of Swords in reverse, just putting an end to drama. Also, though, not acting on your impulses. That's your energy, Gemini. You know, just taking a step back. Now, you see yourself right now as the Two of Cups in reverse. You just have had a falling out, or you feel like it may have been a strong connection at one point, soulmate shit, but you just are not seeing eye to eye. Or you just want to get out of this. Why is this Two of Cups in reverse for Gemini? The Nine of Pentacles in reverse. This is a relationship. You may feel tied and bound to this situation for whatever reason. You know, you're trying to release it and you want to. The Nine of Pentacles in reverse can be, you know, there's financial issues, so I can't quite get out of this yet. I'm codependent on this person because of stability or finances. But also the Nine of Pentacles in reverse is somebody that's in a relationship. You guys want to, you know, release that. Why is this Nine of Pentacles in reverse? Yeah, the Page of Cups, because you guys want new love. I'm just saying. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces energy. Page of Cups is going after something new. It's typically new love. It's opening the door. It's a page, so it would be new. Why the Page of Cups? The Ten of Pentacles in reverse. But you guys know that you have to end something first. You have three tens here, okay? Now, in your environment, you have somebody bringing the wand. Gemini, you do. What's this Ace of Wands coming in for Gemini? Why are they bringing the Ace of Wands? Well, it's the Wheel of Fortune. They want change. They may be waiting for you to get out of something too. The Wheel of Fortune is destiny. It's God's work, right? It's good changes. This person wants a new beginning with you, or, you know, has a lot of passion and wants to take action in some way. The Wheel of Fortune, they're waiting for change, right? Why is this Wheel of Fortune here? What's this Wheel of Fortune about? Yeah, the Eight of Cups in reverse. They want to return to you, or they already have, okay? That might be this Ace of Cups that you have on your mind. This person wants to return. What's this Eight of Cups in reverse? Why is this Eight of Cups in reverse for Gemini's environment? Death. It might be a Scorpio. What do you know? The Death card shows up. This is a transformation, okay? Somebody in your environment wants to go through a transformation. And the Two of Swords, but they know that there's a decision that has to be made. Libra and energy, Two of Swords. They may feel a little bit blocked, or, you know, ignoring their intuition. You may have to ignore the connection for a little while because it seems like you guys are kind of stuck in something. Now, in your emotions, Gemini, you have the Four of Cups in reverse. Why is this Four of Cups in reverse? In Gemini's emotions, what is it? The Queen of Pentacles in reverse. So see, this is somebody, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. This is, you know, the Queen of Cups, obviously, in the upright is all about commitment. She's a mom. She's a wife. She wants long-term, beautiful, nurturing, grounded, beautiful long-term energy. But in reverse, not so much. She's more focused on herself or work or anything about the relationship. So in your emotions, we have this energy of like a missed opportunity and to not really want to give any more stability or long-term. Yeah, the Eight of Wands. You guys just want to release. And also, I think a lot of you want new love with the Eight of Wands. You may already be communicating that. Eight of Wands is the arrows of love. It's fast movement. It's moving forward. Yeah, the Ten of Cups. A lot of you want to release the marriage or the commitment, but a lot of you guys just want to get your happiness back here with the Ten of Cups in your emotions. Yes, and hi, thanks for showing up again, the Lover's card. So you're making a very important decision. I think a lot of you guys also feel a strong connection with somebody else. What's the Lover's about? Yeah, the Knight of Pentacles, but you're moving slowly and carefully. You're trying to be responsible, and you know it's going to take some time here because you're feeling trapped in something else. Now the outcome, we have the Ten of Coins in reverse. Why is this the outcome for Gemini? What is it? The Two of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, something's getting dropped. Remember, you know, time is fluid, okay? So take this when it happens. I'm concentrating the 1st through the 15th, but that's not going to be the time frame for everybody. But there is an ending here to either a commitment or a marriage, okay? It's just, it is. It's being dropped. A lot of earth energy. Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. What's this Two of Pentacles in reverse? The Sun. In order to get your happiness back, right? Leo energy. Again, some of you could be dealing with Leo in their chart, but the Sun is happiness. It's illumination. So after completing a cycle, you're now able to have new beginnings. And I think you already have that on your mind. You know, I do. Yeah. And then the Knight of Cups. And then here comes the new love offer. Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. All right. Here comes the offer. What's this Knight of Cups for Gemini? The Five of Swords, but somebody's going to have to get cut out first, probably, with that Five of Swords energy. Somebody may not be real happy about it. I'm just saying. Yeah, the King of Wands, so there's that Leo energy. Some of you guys are dealing with somebody with earth or fire in their chart. Tell us who this King of Wands is here. Could be male or female, doesn't matter. It doesn't. King of Wands, Ace of Pentacles, a brand new beginning. Somebody's taking action here. You're stuck in something. You have something new on your mind. They want to come in with a passionate new beginning. You're trying to release a relationship, get over the past. You see as it's kind of done, dropping it. This person in your environment, probably the newer connection, wants to come in, has a lot of passion, and wants this new beginning. Could have been somebody you guys were already dealing with, because they do have the Eight of Cups in reverse. So maybe you know them from a previous time. Who knows? But here they come with the Eight of Cups in reverse. And it shows that you will eventually get out of whatever this is, and then you have these new beginnings with the Ace of Pentacles. And one more card on the Ace of Pentacles. Judgment in reverse, but you're going to have to make a decision to end something else first. Judgment in reverse is a lack of a resurrection. It could be a divorce, something like that. You know, not giving something a second chance so that you can get this Ace of Pentacles, which is a, you know, stable new beginning that has potential. Let's check out the King of Coins again and see who this is. Who's this King of Coins? Who's the King of Coins for Gemini? Who is it? Ooh, it's the High Priestess. Okay. So could be somebody that you're keeping under wraps. That High Priestess could be, you're trying to use your intuition as well, but the High Priestess is very aloof, very silent, very closed off energy. Something surrounding this King of Pentacles. Give me more on the High Priestess. What is it? The Ace of Wands. Some of you may not be telling this person that you want a new beginning in a different direction. It's kind of what I'm feeling. What's the Ace of Wands? Or this is them doing this to you. What's this Ace of Wands about? Yeah, the Queen of Wands, taking action. Leo, Sag, Aries energy. I feel like, because that Queen of Wands will make shit happen, but there's something around this very strong commitment, husband, Aries, you know, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy here. Something is being held, kept from this person with that High Priestess and, you know, in the upright, it's secrets or it's being aloof. It's not expressing yourself. And it has something to do with a passionate new beginning. Ace of Wands and the Queen of Wands. But I don't think it's directed towards this King of Pentacles, Aries, Emperor energy. It's a new direction. The Ten of Wands. And there's a lot of burdens, okay? Another 10, completing of cycles. So Gemini, to sum it up, I think you guys are feeling a little bit trapped and you're releasing though. The timing may just not be right. You've got somebody new on your mind. They're coming in, but you have to get out of something else first is what I'm feeling. And it looks like you will. All right. But there are some burdens here. And, you know, something's not being revealed quite yet. And I think it has to do with a passionate new beginning, moving forward and taking action. But maybe this energy doesn't quite know that yet. All right, so that's what I have for you guys. Love you hard. Love me hard back, and we'll speak soon. Take care.